pode ter a oportunidade de reduzir em 80% a probabilidade de ter a enfermidade de uma forma grave morrer ou estar protegido, eu creio que as pessoas não deveriam fazer essa mala decisão.
Em inglês, diz: Cuba has been reporting daily record highs in COVID-19 cases for the past month. Why did it get to this point and how can Cuba turn things around?
Informado que se aplicaron las medidas de contención y de vigilancia en esos lugares, el turismo masivo sigue cerrado en Cuba. De tal manera que las áreas donde se abrieron fueron específicamente Varadero y Los Cayos. Todo lo demás aumentaron. Hay signos positivos. El incremento que siga así.
Tenemos todavía varias preguntas vinculadas con variante Delta, Kevon Felmain, Guardian Media en Trinidad y Tobago en inglés dice: Can you provide the Delta variant, particularly in the Caribbean? Has there been any community spread or new clusters detected anywhere? And Melina Ochoa de UNOTV en México también pregunta: If the Delta variant is more dangerous and would it change the rules of vaccination? Doctora Edian.
So, Let me thank Kevon for this question. And let me put this in perspective. Viruses have one goal: to multiply and to survive. So they are bound to become more contagious over time. And that's what we are seeing with the SARS-CoV-2 virus that causes COVID-19. The Delta variant spreads more easily. So it is driving infections, and in some cases, reinfections in our region and around the world. So as of August 2nd, 22 countries in our region have detected the presence of the Delta variant, including 10 countries and territories in the Caribbean. Many of these detections were associated with travelers. We are seeing community transmission of the Delta variant in Ecuador, Mexico, and the United States of America. PAHO has supported the countries through its regional genomic surveillance network, which helped 49 countries and territories in our region to detect variants of concerns that are now referred to as Alpha, Beta, Gamma, and Delta. So this is concerning because cases seem to spread more easily with the Delta variant. So we really cannot afford to let our guard down. According to the evidence available so far, all of the vaccines that have been licensed by WHO protect against all the variants, including Delta, and they significantly decrease the risk of hospitalization and death. So they continue to be a powerful tool to fight the virus, and thank goodness. And that is why we need more vaccines now for Latin America and Europe. And this is why we